Hi everyone, in this video I am going to explain about the topic Megasporogenesis, development of Megaspore. Okay, We all know the structure of ovule. In the ovule, new cellulose tissue is present. This new cellulose tissue is surrounded by integuments. In the new cellulose tissue, one of the hypodermal cell is differentiated to form archisporial cell. This archisporial cell divides periclinally to form two cells, outer cell and inner cell. Outer cell is called parietal cell and inner cell is called sporogenous cell. This parietal cell divide and redivide to produce parietal tissue, and the sporogenous cell divide to produce megaspore mother cell. This cell is developed into megaspore mother cell. This megaspore mother cell take part in the development of embryo sac. Okay, are you understand? This only showing in this slide. In the first diagram, one of the hypodermal cell of the new cellulose is differentiated to form archisporial cell. This archisporial cell divide to produce outer parietal cell and inner sporogenous cell. This sporogenous cell further divide to produce further differentiated to form megaspore mother cell. This megaspore mother cell divide to produce four haploid cells. They are arranged in a linear fashion. These four haploid cells are formed. They are arranged in a linear fashion. They are also called linear tetrad, or otherwise they are also known as megaspore tetrads. Okay, these four megaspore tetrads take part in the development of embryo sac. Are you understand? Okay, the development of female gametophyte always starts with the formation of megaspore. Based on the number of megaspores involved in the formation of embryo sac, three types of embryo sac developments are recognized. They are number one, monosporic type, and number two, bisporic type, and number three, tetrasporic type. Already we are discussed that the megaspore mother cell undergoes meiotic division to form four megaspores or four megaspore nuclei. In monosporic type, one of the megaspore is take part in the development of embryo sac. Otherwise, one of the megaspore nuclei take part in the development of embryo sac. That type of development is called monosporic type of embryo sac development. And second one is bisporic type of embryo sac development. In this, the megaspore mother cell undergoes meiotic division, resulting in the formation of two dyads. They are diploid in condition. Otherwise, it forms four haploid megaspores. In these, one dyad or two megaspores take part in the development of embryo sac. That's why it is called bisporic type. Bi means two megaspores, otherwise diploid dyad is take part in the development of embryo sac development. So it is called bisporic type. Next one is tetrasporic type. In the tetrasporic type, megaspore mother cell undergoes meiotic division, resulting in the formation of 4 megaspores. All these 4 megaspores take part in the development of embryo sac development, embryo sac formation. Okay. Then I would like to discuss development of embryo sacs one by one. Okay. Right. First, I want to discuss about monosporic type of embryo sac development. On the basis of number of nuclei present in the mature embryo sac, Maheshwari recognized mainly 2 types of embryo sac. They are 8 nucleated type, and second one is 4 nucleated type. How the development takes place in the 8 nucleate type and how the development takes place in 4 nucleate type, I will discuss in the next slide. Okay, right. Coming to next slide, first one is 8 nucleated type. Okay, in this 8 nucleated type, it was first discovered by Strasburger in polygonum divaricatum, so that it is also called polygonum type. It is commonly called polygonum type. It is a common type of embryo sac development. It is found in angiosperms. It is a normal type. Once again, I am repeating this. 8 nucleated type embryo sac development is first time observed by Strasburger in polygonum divaricatum. It is most common type of embryo sac development. It is found in angiosperms. It is also called normal type of embryo sac development. How the embryo sac development takes place in this 8 nucleated type, now I am going to explain. Okay, first, what happens? Already we know that megaspore mother cell undergoes meiotic division, resulting in the formation of 4 megaspores. Out of these 4 megaspores, only 1 megaspore or megaspore nuclei take part in the development of embryo sac. Okay, now see here, total 4 megaspores are formed after meiotic division in the megaspore mother cell. These are 4 megaspores, out of which 3 megaspores present towards the micropyle are degenerate, and remaining 1 megaspore present towards the chalaza is functional. This is the functional megaspore. This functional megaspore take part in the development of embryo sac development. These 3 are degenerated. Only single megaspore take part in the development of embryo sac. Hence, it is called monosporic type. This single functional megaspore increase in the size by absorbing food materials, and which also takes cytoplasm and develops plasma membrane around it. Then what happens? The nucleus also increase in the size, and this nucleus undergoes 1 mitotic division, resulting in the formation of 2 nuclei. These 2 nuclei then shows polar differentiation. That means out of 2 nuclei, one is moved towards the micropyle and another one is moved towards the chalaza. Then another division takes place in these two nuclei. Then what happens? Two nuclei are formed towards the micropyle and two nuclei are formed towards the chalaza. Then another mitotic division takes place in this in these four nuclei. Then what happens? Total four nuclei are formed towards the micropyle and four nuclei are formed towards the chalaza, of which three nuclei secrete plasma membrane around them and form egg apparatus towards the micropyle. What happened here? Three nuclei, they form plasma membrane around them and they are involved in the formation of egg apparatus towards the micropyle. Okay, remaining one nuclei is present near to egg apparatus. Then four nuclei are present towards the chalaza, out of which three nuclei secrete plasma membrane around them and they form antipodals towards the chalaza. One more nucleus or cell is present towards the chalaza. Then what happens? The upper and lower polar nuclei migrates towards the center. They move towards the center of the embryo sac and fuse together to form secondary nucleus. This secondary nucleus is generally in diploid condition. Okay, that means in this 8 nucleated type, how many nuclei are present in the mature embryo sac? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is diploid in condition, so that 2. Total 8 nuclei are present in the mature embryo sac. How many cells are present in this embryo sac? Total 7 cells and 8 nucleated embryo sac. This embryo sac is also called as polygonum type. Okay, this is about monosporic embryo sac development. In the next video, I will come with second type, that is bisporic embryo sac development.